Let's take a look at the halogenoalkanes. Halogenoalkanes can be classified as primary, secondary, or tertiary. Here's an example here. So we have the halogen, which is bromine. It's attached to this carbon here, and this carbon is attached to one other carbon and two hydrogen atoms. That makes it a primary halogenoalkane. In this example here, we have the bromine atom again, and it's attached to this carbon, and this carbon is attached to two other carbons and one other hydrogen, so that's a secondary halogenoalkane. Here we have the bromine, it's attached to the carbon atom. This carbon atom is attached to one, two, three other carbon atoms, so that makes it a tertiary halogenoalkane. Next, let's look at the substitution nucleophilic reactions of the halogenoalkanes. Halogenoalkanes react with sodium hydroxide, NaOH, in substitution reactions. The hydroxide ion, which is OH negative, is a nucleophile. That means it's attracted to a region of positive charge. The hydroxide ion will take the place of, or substitute, the halogen. The halogenoalkane is converted to an alcohol. Next, let's look at SN1 reactions, substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. So tertiary halogenoalkanes undergo SN1 reactions. A tertiary halogenoalkane will form a tertiary alcohol. It's a two-step reaction. The rate depends on the concentration of the NaOH and the halogenoalkane. A carbocation or a positive ion is formed. This is the first step here. We have a tertiary halogenoalkane. Now you'll notice that the carbon is a little bit positive and the chlorine is a little bit negative. That's because of the difference in electronegativity between the carbon and the chlorine, which makes it a polar bond. Here we have a curly arrow. The curly arrow shows movement of a pair of electrons. Here we have the carbocation. So what's happened here, the Cl atom has broken off, if you like, from the molecule, and we're left with a positive ion or a carbocation. In the second step, here we have the hydroxide ion, which is the nucleophile. It's attracted to the carbon because the carbon is now a positive ion. Now, you draw a curly arrow, and the curly arrow must go from the pair of electrons on the oxygen atom to where the bond will be formed, which is about here. And then on the right side, the OH has joined with the carbon, and that gives us a tertiary alcohol. So next, it's SN2 reactions, and SN2 stands for substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. So this time, it's primary halogenoalkanes. They undergo SN2 reactions. The primary halogenoalkane will form a primary alcohol. It's a one-step reaction. The rate depends on the concentration of the halogenoalkane only. An unstable intermediate or transition state is formed. So here's the mechanism. So we have a primary halogenoalkane here. Just like SN2, the carbon is a little bit positive and the chlorine is a little bit negative because of the difference in the electronegativity between the carbon and the chlorine, which makes it a polar bond. Again, we have a curly arrow going to the chlorine, which shows movement of a pair of electrons. And on the left here, we have the same nucleophile, the hydroxide ion, and a curly arrow again. Remember, the curly arrow must go from a pair of electrons on the oxygen atom. Now the difference in an SN2 reaction is that we have a transition state. Now in the transition state, the OH and the Cl are both joined to the carbon, okay? And that's called the transition state. And then we have the primary alcohol, the OH group is joined here. So we have a primary alcohol and the chloride ion has left. Let's have a quick summary. A substitution nucleophilic reaction involves the replacement of an atom by a nucleophile, which is a species with a lone pair of electrons that is attracted to a region of positive charge. Primary halogenoalkanes undergo SN2 reactions to form a primary alcohol. Tertiary halogenoalkanes undergo SN1 reactions to form a tertiary alcohol. Secondary halogenoalkanes undergo both SN1 and SN2 reactions.